Welcome back to Hypnosis Today, where we explore how people are using hypnosis to achieve remarkable things. My second guests are Bryce LaRue. Now, Bryce is an honors grad of HMI College of Hypnotherapy. He's also a winner of the prestigious Director's Award, and he also won the award for clinical excellence. Now, Bryce has with him his very special guest, Maggie. Maggie came in to see Bryce to have confidence to pursue her dream without fear. Please help me welcome my guests.
Thank you.
Maggie, I want to start with you. What was going on?
I was transitioning from the corporate world to starting my own business, and that involved public speaking, which I felt was my purpose and my passion, but I had major fears and lack of confidence. So I did a lot of work on the conscious level, you know, personal development courses, spiritual development, but there was still a lack of connection. Something wasn't clicking. And so I came in here and worked with Bryce to get the confidence at a subconscious level, and that's what catapulted my growth tremendously.
How did you even meet Bryce?
Through a coworker.
What do you mean?
I work in a corporate job now, and one of my clients, or one of my coworkers, who is one of my coaching clients now, had been going to Bryce for a few months and had told me about it, and I was resistant at first. I'd never done hypnotherapy. After a few weeks of her telling me the tremendous growth she had had, I said, okay, I've got to try this. So I went.
Bryce, I have to commend you because you are your reputation. And the very best way to get clients is referral from other clients. Mm-hmm. Now, we don't ask, do you know anybody? But just by being your most excellent self, you will get referrals, and that's how you found him. Now, I'm going to pick up on something that you said.
Okay.
You said, at first, I was very resistant to hypnotherapy.
Yeah.
What was it that was just a little scary, or there was just a little resistance to hypnotherapy? What was the myth that you had?
The loss of control.
Do you know, Maggie, that no one ever goes to see a hypnotherapist to lose control? The only reason anyone sees a hypnotherapist is to get more control over his or her life.
Yeah.
Did you completely lose control and did you go under his Svengali-like power?
Mm-mm, I had complete control.
And what do you mean? What did it feel like?
I was able to put all of the knowledge and growth and information that I'd been gathering into use. I was able to really bring it through. Instead of it being outside of myself, I was able to bring it in, and I was able to bridge the gap between who I am now and this higher self that I had dreamt about and who I knew I was. I was able to really bring that forth and become one with that through hypnosis.
Well, see, you were telling me that you had a corporate job, but you wanted to transition into your passion.
Yes.
And there was a fear of public speaking. Was there also a fear of releasing and going for it and being able to do it and having the authenticity to do it?
Absolutely, all of the above. And there was a big lack of true self-worth. Like, can I do this? Who am I to be a spiritual teacher, to be a life coach? And the confidence, the lack of self-worth was all worked on through hypnosis at such a deep level, and it stuck.
Well, I'll tell you something just between you and me, but don't tell the 2 million people watching. Women are more susceptible to the imposter syndrome. Who am I to do these amazing things?
Yeah.
Bryce, I want to go to you. When we have someone who really wants to release the fear and pursue that dream, what kind of hypnosis do you use? Can you teach us something?
Absolutely. So when I do confidence, I always start with a long, deep, progressive guided relaxation that I tie into my client's breathing to make sure that all the stressors and all the anxiety from that day goes away.
Because you can't do hypnosis when someone's still holding on to the anxiety of the day. So that's brilliant.
Absolutely.
What was it like releasing? Well, I used to work for a corporation too. I won't mention its name since we're on the air. What was it like being able to have a sanctuary, a sacred place, a sacred space to release the anxiety of the day?
It was the first time in my entire life that I had learned to relax. I never knew what that meant. I was always go, 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 moving 1,000 miles a minute. And finally, Bryce was able to teach me how to slow down and relax and what relaxation even meant. So it was huge.
That's huge. Now, once we get our client into hypnosis for confidence, what do we do next?
So you don't want it to be only a quick fix for the day of the session. You want it to be a lasting process. And for this, I use a very powerful tool that is called an anchor.
An anchor? It sounds like something you throw off a boat.
It can be. That's also can be either a word or a physical reminder that we associate under hypnosis with a positive state that the client wants to reach and that the client will be able to recreate in their life whenever they need or want to experience that positive state again. It's like confidence or motivation on demand.
So show me how to do it.
So one thing that I use a lot with my clients is the OK sign. Exactly. So bring the thumb and the index finger together. Everybody can do it. But before I do that, I always ask my client to think about a moment in their life when they felt like they were at the top of their game. Could be a graduation day, could be their wedding day, like any moment they choose. And I really, my job as a hypnotherapist is to bring back the feelings and the emotions and the positive state that they felt on this specific moment of their life, and to have them brighten up the colors, make the sounds louder, make the emotions as vivid and real as I can when they're on the chair in my office. And when they get there, I make them do the OK sign, and I create this subconscious association between that positive state that they're able to feel because they've already felt it, so now they know that they can feel it again, and that physical anchor that becomes instantly a physical reminder.
Well, I'm going to tell you something that your client, my friend Maggie, said. She said she had a fear of public speaking. How can you use that for public speaking, Brice?
The OK sign is actually a really good tool for public speaking.
How come?
Because first, you can vary the intensity of the pressure that you apply between your fingers. So you can press a little more when it gets a little white like this. That's something that I program under hypnosis. And I tell my clients that the more pressure they're going to apply doing the OK sign in a fully awakened state when they're back home, and the more confidence they will instantly get. But wait, there's more. When they will be speaking in public, they will obviously talk with their hands because that's what we do when we speak in public, right? Mm-hmm. But they will be able to use the OK sign while they're speaking, not only to send this message to themselves that everything's okay, and they will feel this positive state instantly by doing that, but they will also send an inference to the public, to the audience in the room, that everything they're saying is okay. And so everybody will feel good in the room, not only them.
Boy, neuro-linguistic programming much?
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit. Did you use that when you were doing your public speaking?
Oh, every time. I used it before I got on stage for this.
You did?
Yeah.
So we can talk to the audience like this. Mm-hmm. Let's all do it. Feel okay? Good. The proof is in the pudding, Maggie. Tell me, how has your life changed since you came in to see Brice?
Tremendously. I am able to make my dreams come into reality. I hosted my first wellness retreat 2 weeks ago where I was speaking to an audience of 20 people all weekend. That never would have happened if I had these fears in the way and this inability to speak my truth. And through this, the confidence that I gained and the connection to my authentic voice, I had nothing in the way. It was me, my voice, and an engaged audience.
And what's next for you?
I'm going to India to do a community service project, to do some personal development work with children and get my yoga certification.
Do you think you could have done that without this type of confidence?
I don't. I really don't.
What would you say to someone who's thinking of hypnotherapy but is afraid that Svengali over here is going to take away their will?
I would say that if they're meditators, it's similar to meditation in that you're in complete control at all times. You are accessing a higher power that you don't have access to without this alternate subconscious level. So you're just accessing more of yourself. There's nothing outside of you. It's a higher power, a facilitator that is able to tap into stuff that you don't want to look at or that you're not ready to look at, and move out the blind spots and connect you to your highest good.
And what would you say about working with Brees specifically?
There were so many moments where I forgot that you were a facilitator and that I was a patient or a guest. I mean, it felt like we were just one, and minutes would turn into hours, and there was no separation. You were completely with me every step of the way. You were feeling my victories, you were feeling my pains, and it was the most incredible experience I could have ever imagined. I mean, I would not be here without you. I tell you all the time. I want to tell you more, but sometimes I'm like, I shouldn't bother you, but I want to shower you with gratitude for, thank you for being such a fundamental part of me.
Thank you very
finding
much.
Myself.
You know, Brees, it is the best of being a wonderful hypnotherapist, but also having unconditional positive regard for your client. And it is an honor to have you on my program.
Thank you very much. I know
that everybody is going to want to have hypnotherapy with Brees LaRue. Do you speak any other languages besides English?
Yes, I do. I'm fluent in French.
Wow. So anybody who's in Southern California can come into the office and see Brees LaRue. Do you Skype or FaceTime?
I absolutely do. Mm-hmm.
So if you're any place on this planet called Earth and you would like a session with Brees LaRue in French or in English, you can reach Brees LaRue at hmigrads.com. It appears we're out of time. First, I want to thank my magnificent guest, Maggie, for being so honest and sharing your experience. And I want to wish you all the luck in the world to pursue your amazing dreams, because you are a vessel of light. I want to thank Brees LaRue. I want to thank everybody here in our studio audience and those of you watching at home. My name is Lisa Mackenberg, and I'll see you next time on Hypnosis Today. But please stay tuned. We got a lot more coming up for you here at Hypnosis TV. Stay tuned.
Thank you.